When you see the goodness of God, you move in the goodness of God. The Lord says, even if there are 10 people in that city, good people, I will never destroy. I am a God of goodness. I am God of love. Yes. The man who cheated him, Abraham, showed goodness. And that's why when Abraham was in trouble, God saved him. God, without knowing, Abraham told his wife Sarah, tell that you are my sister. And Abimelech wanted to take that wife of Abraham. God said to Abimelech in the dream, don't touch Sarah. She is the wife of my prophet. First time the word prophet is given for Abraham from the mouth of God. Prophet is one who takes the people's prayer to God and bring God's answer to the people. You can be a prophet through your intercession, carrying all the prayers, tears, and pain of this world to God and bringing God's grace, mercy, and love to this sinful world. If you look into the world may not be good to you. It may even curse you. It may forget you. It may do harm to you. Actually, Lot did harm. He took away the best which was given to Abraham. Jesus is, after showing so much of goodness, he speaks about goodness. And then when he comes out, a man comes and says, look, look, I have a desire. I have a desire to follow you. But I have to go and say goodbye to my family. When you get the light of brightness, you have to move with the light. You cannot get back into darkness. Once you get back into darkness, again you will be tied up. If God has called you for a program, for a way of life, you have to be there only. The moment we turn back, once again, what is in the dirt? What is in the dark? What is their problem, their situation? All that gets back into your mind. Then what God wanted to do through you gets stopped. It's like I am in the light. So the warmth of the light, the brightness of the light that comes. Suddenly I turn back and go, and the warmth is gone. And what are the things in the darkness? Maybe snake bites. Maybe I am fallen without knowing the path. And again to get up with that wounds is not possible. Once I go there, I get stuck up. I will have issues of that darkness. If I have fallen, then I have to go to the doctor. I have to find my wounds. Busy with that, or when I go back home, when God has called me for a call, for a purpose, and God's home, God's plan, God's dream, God's vision has to rule my life. Day and night we should be with the word. We should become filled with the goodness of God, and then we become great intercessors like Abraham, bringing goodness of God to the people who are hatred, who are filled with anger, who are having all kinds of problems. That's so the answer of Jesus is very interesting. He says, what was the answer? The birds have nests and the foxes have holes, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. What is the meaning of that? Birds have nest. The foxes have holes. Once the birds get into that, they are safe, they think. The foxes, if they go into the deep pit, even if the lion comes, anything wants to eat, it cannot. It will be safe in the hole. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Jesus has no resting place, because his resting place is, where is his resting place? First Corinthians 3:16. Don't you know your heart is God's temple? They think they in the birds, when they get into the nest, what do they do? Keep their eyes opened 24 hours. In the nest, what do? They close their eyes. In the pit, what do the folks do? They close their eyes. But the eyes of the Lord never gets closed. 2 Chronicles 16:9. The eyes of the Lord roam around the world like the bird, not in the nest, like the bird roaming in the sky. The eyes of the Lord are always upon his people. For what? To strengthen them, to bring them back to life. Read that beautiful sentence. 2 Chronicles 16:9. For the eyes of the Lord always roaming around the world. For what? To strengthen those whose heart is on him. Okay. So he talks to, this is about the king of Asa. He did not depend on God. God did so much for the king of Asa, and he did not trust in God. So the Lord's prophet comes and tells him, you don't depend on God. Do you know who is your God? Your God's eyes are always on those who trust him. You are trusting on other kings, the world, and they are going to destroy you. Only the eyes of God will be always on you. That's what the Lord said to the king called Asa. Now here Jesus says, the eyes of the Lord are always open on the cross for us.